Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Game on. It's brought to you by
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
Hours to the start of match day two, Group A, Uganda Cranes up against the Warriors in Zimbabwe in what should be a very interesting affair, because then one more win for Uganda Cranes will have them march into the round of 16. Meanwhile, in the FIFA Women's World Cup, it is now down to the quarterfinals, whereby the Dutch ladies managed to upset the Japanese, setting up a date with the side in Italy, who also got the job done against China. Very warm welcome to Game On. It is yet another fine day, 26th June 2019. We shall be getting into the AFCON conversation later on with a former FIFA official, one who took part in the 2002 FIFA World Cup, and that is, of course, none other than Ali Tomsanga. But as of now, we'll be talking about muscles, that is triceps and biceps, and this is all about the national colors way down in Egypt, with African Cup of Nations will be prevailing through. Now, myself, Nicholas Nomatrubuwe, and of course, Brian Essima, looking all dull, but hopefully by the end of the night, we'll be looking all energetic. Before I get to you, let's talk muscles before, you know, you need to kind of step away from fair enough. Yakubu.
Yes, my brother.
Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
I need to have you have your moment. I don't have the big biceps or the triceps, neither does Brian. I like to take the shirt together, but quite the body you have over there. And this has a lot to do with the forthcoming event. Tell us about you and the forthcoming event this coming weekend in Masaka.
Yes, thank you so much for hosting me, Aban TV. My name is Yakubu bin Hassan. I'm a bodybuilder, stroke fitness trainer. I train at Royal Suits. I'm here to tell everybody about the events, the bodybuilding, Mr. Kampala bodybuilding competition that is on Sunday, 30th this week. Mm-hmm. Yep, it's gonna be amazing show. It's gonna be grateful. Yeah, you should come and see the inspiring body. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we have girls, we have good men with good muscles, bicep, triceps, yeah.
I always say it's a bunch of naked men, you know, just showing up, you know,
the underwear
and all that. But Brian, good afternoon to you. Hope you're well.
I'm certainly doing awesome. Just like the colors in my jersey, certainly
luck.
Show. Everything is looking towards the Uganda Cranes. Mm-hmm. And that's, I think, for me, where my mind is at, thinking the Uganda Cranes and the game ahead.
Not thinking the muscles next to you. But just out of the book, I mean, would you love to have such a body? I'm just saying.
Well, truth be told, no. Why?
I'll be honest. I will want to have something like that, but not as huge as that. I mean, walking around with your girlfriend and she's wrapping her arm around you. Mm. What does she feel? A bunch of bones. Yakub.
Yes, my brother.
I went with the fun side of it. You have an event coming through, and I think for my end, there's a feeling that you need to go out there and better from what you achieved the last time. Of course, the last time you came through, what, third place?
Yes.
This being your third time to take part in the Mr. Kampala.
Yes.
What hurts it that Lwanga Lamek, the defending champion,
yes,
won't be taking part? Is this an advantage for your side?
Yes, actually, not really, because last time the Lwanga beat all of us because I didn't work out my back enough. Mm-hmm. But these times, I really focused so hard on my back muscles. Mm-hmm. And I believe that this time around, I'm gonna beat everybody builder in this competition that is coming.
Out of curiosity, Yakubu, what do they look at? I mean, I've seen the poses, you know,
yes, and all that.
And I'm thinking, what do they look out for? Because even then, when you have the biggest of muscles, it doesn't necessarily guarantee you victory.
Yes. So in bodybuilding competition, the judges focus more on the lean muscles, shredded, ripped. Mm-hmm. It's not all about being just bulky, big, and you think that you're going to take the crown. Mm-hmm. They focus on the mass, the size of your muscles, and the definition, how you're defined.
As a whole?
Yeah, as a whole body. Mm-hmm. Your shoulder, your tricep, bicep, forearms, your quad, hamstring, and the calf. Mm-hmm. So a bodybuilder, you have to be fully packed with muscles.
Right from
like here. The way you can see me, shoulder, chest, 10 packs. Mm-hmm. Me, I have 10 packs, bro.
How many packs do you have, Brian?
Six pack is nothing. Take a brief one.
Quickly, Yakub, when you look at bodybuilding as a sport in this country,
yes, my brother,
it's not as eye-catching as, you know, I'll probably want to believe in terms of how many people, the following.
Yes.
Do you think in the long run, or do you think that bodybuilding is a promising sport in that regard? Because again, it's not an everyday sport. It's probably once in a while when you have such events,
yes,
until maybe you have global events. Yes. Do you think bodybuilding has actually done much to, you know, be out there in the public?
Not really. Bodybuilding has been a little bit low in terms of sport. Mm-hmm. But this time, we are really working so hard to make sure that we put it before the people. Because this is something that is health for everybody. Mm-hmm. Because me, Hassan, Bin Hassan, I believe that everybody is a bodybuilder. Mm-hmm. Because bodybuilding is fitness, it's mm-hmm. healthy, mm-hmm. and it's life. Mm-hmm. My brother, I'm telling you. That's why in the United States of America, they focus on bodybuilding as a priority.
Mm-hmm. Brown, you look at such a sport like bodybuilding. I know you and I, you know, are not yet there in terms of size, but for a sport like bodybuilding, do you think that he mentions the word health, that it's healthy, but when you hear things of people taking injections just to have calories or just to add more sap on their body muscles, is that something you think that can be taken away from the sport in bodybuilding?
Absolutely. I actually had a conversation with him before he came on, and mm-hmm. he was telling me about how he gets to have the ripped body that he has. Mm-hmm. He says these natural supplements that mm-hmm. He actually
natural.
Gets. Yes,
natural
supplements. Natural? Well, I think that is something you'd explain mm-hmm. better. But over the years, there's been a conversation of so many people doing so many unhealthy things mm-hmm. just to be able to, you know, get into shape, get ripped, and certainly to be able to compete. And ultimately, for some people, it always comes back and haunts them at a certain point in their lives. So it's quite interesting. You also talk about how much visibility the sport has got mm-hmm. as, you know, bodybuilding and fitness all together. And I think for us as Ugandans, the culture is still quite very low in terms of fitness, in terms mm-hmm. of bodybuilding. So many people attach so many stereotypes mm-hmm. to these kinds of sports. So you found that it goes to just a select couple mm-hmm. of people mm-hmm. that have embraced it all together. So I think as a federation and the guys in charge, they've got plenty of work to do. The good thing they've done is that they've taken the sport mm-hmm. across the country. They've sort of spread it out and taken it to mm-hmm. different places.
Now they're going to Masaka now.
Yeah, they've been in Masaka. They've recently been in Jinja as well. Mm-hmm. It creates that awareness. So mm-hmm. many people get to learn that there's a sport called bodybuilding and you can do such and such a thing to actually mm-hmm. be able to make the cut.
Quickly, Yakubu, how much feeding do you do or does your body consume? Because I would like to believe that every morning, maybe if you wake up, measure your bicep and see, okay, maybe I'm 2 inches less, yeah. I'm 2 inches more. How much feeding do you do in a day?
Actually, me, I do 5 meals.
5 meals a day?
Yeah.
So let's look at breakfast. Uh-huh. Breakfast, you have
breakfast. Mm-hmm. I do breakfast heavy. I can do Katogo and Nyama. So this in local Katogo. Yes.
So in there you have proteins and carbohydrates.
Yeah, I have proteins and carbohydrates, okay. But more of proteins.
Okay,
yeah.
So now we have breakfast, then?
We have breakfast, then in between breakfast and lunch, I also have snack in between.
A snack?
Yes, I can maybe do roasted meat, something like that, and juice.
And then after that, you have another meal?
After that, I have a full package of lunch.
That's lunch, that's
yes.
a main course.
Yes.
And then after lunch, you have one more meal.
In between lunch and supper, I also have some snack in between there.
So this requires like so much, because I spoke to Gola like a couple of weeks back, and he says he spends about roughly 500,000 on food just in a month. And yeah. I'm thinking, that is a whole lot of food you're putting in your body. Do you have like a separate budget for your meals?
It's not really a lot of food, because when you're working out, you burn a lot. When you're in the gym, you burn calories.
Okay.
It's mean. So the food that you eat, the intake, mm-hmm. the food that you do, mm-hmm. you normally burn it and turn it to muscles. Mm-hmm. So if you are a bodybuilder and you lift weights, if you are an athlete, you have to eat enough so that you work out mm-hmm. enough.
Yakubu, there's something at stake besides the 2 million or the 1.5
yeah.
or, the 800,000 cash prize. Musclemania is coming up. Obviously, for you, it's important for you to go out there and get another podium like you did the last time out. What are your primary targets this weekend in Masaka?
In Kampala.
In Kampala,
in Kampala. It is in Kampala. Mm-hmm. Yes, my target and my vision, my focus is to take the crown of Mr. Kampala.
Away from the Luanga.
Away from the Luanga.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, unfortunately, that he's not gonna compete this mm-hmm. time. Yeah, he's afraid. He got scared of me, bro.
Oh, he's already in the country.
Sincerely speaking, to be honest, bro, you can see the muscles. Mm-hmm. The muscles just talks by itself, bro. Look at my bicep. Look at my tricep. Mm-hmm. Have you ever seen a man like me around Kampala? Just feel the muscles, bro.
I've seen a couple of them. They have those bulky shoulders that like that, and you're thinking it's about to fall off. But obviously, you must take pride in what you have, your body. And I do believe that for bodybuilders, that is the precious or the goal that they do possess.
Yes.
For you going out there this weekend, you've spoken about what you think the judges might look out for. But as an individual,
yes,
what do you think you're bringing different this time around compared to the last edition?
Actually, the pose I'm bringing this time is totally different. Mm. Last time in Mr. Uganda bodybuilding competition that happened in Masaka, I had 6 pack. But this time, bro, you have never seen 10 packs, I've got 10 packs this time.
Can we have a look? Just a glimpse.
It's okay, bro. This is just a sample. You
just
can see.
Just a sample.
Yeah.
All right. As we sign out, just one more word to all the followers you have out there ahead of this weekend's Mr. Kampala.
Mr. Kampala.
Can you give them a vow that you're coming out on top with that trophy?
I'm really coming out with that trophy, friends. I've brought in a lot of good new poses. And also, I've really worked on my calf, my quads, my chest, my shoulder. It's really amazing. This time, it's going to be amazing. We are going to change the face of bodybuilding this time around.
Can you have just one more pose? I would like to... Oh, that one.
Just check it up the bicep. Just
that
look.
One. And then we have another one. Any that one. Okay. And then any other?
There is this one.
Oh, that one.
There is this one here.
Okay. I'm amazed by that. Thank you so much, Yakubu Bin Hassan, for coming through. Best of luck to you this coming weekend. Of course, that is Yakubu Bin Hassan coming out to showcase his body structure, the biceps, the triceps, something myself and Brian will be working on in the next maybe 3 or 4 years. But we'll take a small breather. When we get back, Ali Tomusange does get to join me inside to discuss Uganda Cranes up against Zimbabwe tonight in what should be an interesting one.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Game on is brought to you by
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.